It was a lovely spring evening in May, particularly warm for the time of year. A group of students are playing football at Seabrays, which is opposite university. And they're kicking the ball about. One of them kicks the ball over a hedge. It bounces into a garden and very slowly bounces down steps into the basement. One of the lads runs after the ball, shouting at his pals that he's a pure kicker and so on, picks up the ball and is making his way back up when he glances to his right and sees a broken pane of glass. He looks in through the broken glass and to his disbelief finds an absolute horror, sees an elderly couple lying bloodstained on the basement floor. Clearly they were murder victims. Henry Gallagher was a Dundee born lad and troubled upbringing. He'd been in trouble with the police from a very early age and served his first custodial sentence in an approved school at the age of 12. He broke into houses and so on. He was a petty minor criminal, and there'd been no real evidence of a lot of violence in his background until about the age of 22. And this was probably the start of his fixation with priests. He called on the minister, Reverend Roy Hogg, who was the minister of the High Church in Dundee, went to the manse and said that he was seeking some kind of salvation and assistance. He set about him, attacked him quite viciously, finished up tying him up, and then he robbed him and left the minister tied up and just cleared out. So that was his first sort of offence. It was a major investigation. I mean, a crime like that doesn't happen very often anywhere, but the brutal killing of two old folk in their own home was really a major, major offence. And the degree of violence, in fact, Detective Chief and Superintendent Jim Cameron, who was leading the investigation, who'd seen his fair share of brutal murders, was absolutely horrified at the violence that was used and did say at one point that really this wasn't normal at all. And he called on the underground, the underworld, to assist, to say, look, even you would be horrified. He got a lot of responses from that, but absolutely nothing that really kind of pointed them in the right direction. And then they received a phone call from a lady saying that, earlier in the afternoon, on the day of the killings, on the Saturday afternoon, an odd-looking man had appeared at the house asking for the address of the Bishop of Dunkeld, who lived further down Rose Angle. He was then seen in the garden of the bishop's house, again looking a bit odd, and that kind of gave them a bit of a clue who they might be looking for that could be the same person. It wasn't until a few days afterwards that they really began to get definitely on the track of Gallagher. What happened, and it was purely coincidental, the copy of the latest edition of the Police Gazette, which is a police bulletin which is circulated around police forces in Britain, arrived in Bell Street, and one of the detectives, the detective inspector William Hart, who was very much a major player in the investigation, saw the police bulletin which identified Gallagher as having absconded from Maidstone. Detective Inspector Hart then began to put two and two together, and he recalled the case of the Roy Hogg, the minister in Dundee, who was badly beaten up, and began to think, I wonder if this is the same person who had committed the offence in Dundee. Got in touch with their colleagues down south and said, look, I think we may well be looking for the same man. We've got brutal killings here, which are almost a textbook for what's happened in Ramsgate. And we know that this man, Gallagher, has a thing about attacking priests in their own home. So that it became clear then that this Gallagher suddenly went overnight from being a petty criminal to the most hunted man in Britain, with four brutal killings behind him, all within the space of really a week.